Hey everybody, it's Brickwaffle again, and we are back on Ark Survival Evolved on the Scorched Earth server, and we have our Argentavis. Isn't he pretty? Well, she's pretty. And she's leveled up again. We're 92. We're going to keep working on health. We've gotten quite a bit of XP since the last episode, even though it hasn't been that long for me. I'm trying to record these all in the same weekend for you guys. But I went ahead and made a couple of things. So I made my longneck rifle, which is great. We don't have enough to make a lot of ammo for it. We need to burn up some more charcoal at some point. But now we can do a Rex saddle. And while that's crafting, we can cook up something else over here, which is the industrial grill. Turn that on. Craft item. There we go. So that's going to give us a bunch more XP. It's just really nice how fast this comes in once you have the materials for it. Drop that for now. And let's see. We've got, what do we need? We've got some charcoal in here. In terms of ammo, we need gunpowder. That's really it. And in order to get gunpowder, we need spark powder and charcoal. So we're going to throw a bunch of wood in our industrial grill once that's cooked up too. So turn that off. Doing all right in all the metal and things. Let's see. Put that. Let's just use it. And where can we put this? Oof. Can we put you right on the ground? We can't. How about right at the edge of this thing? There we go. Are you hanging off the edge? A little bit. Not ideal, but that's okay. We can still get to the fabricator. We can get into this thing. And let's grab 100 gasoline from there. Throw that in here. And then we're going to need to get some, I think, wood from in here somewhere. Do we have much? We don't have much wood. We got 106 wood there. And what about in here? Anything? Oh, I don't even need that. That needs to go into our blueprints chest. I forgot we had that other box in there. Do we have any wood in our smithy? We do. 49 more wood in there. And I'm pretty sure if I burn it this way, I'm going to get... I can't do it. Oh, no. All right. Well, we're going to have to just cook that up in a cook fire. Or in our forge? Yeah, let's do that. Take that out. Take that out. Put all that stuff in and light the fire. We're just going to get that charcoal going. And when we come back, that'll all be charcoal. Let's see, put this in here. Put the spark powder in there for now. And then we've got the metal ingots. We've got our extra spark powder. That's going to... Actually, let's go ahead and grab that too while we're at it. Because that is going to be what we need in this mortar and pestle. There we go. Oh, we do have some gunpowder in here too. Great. Can we craft? We can craft one. That's fine. We'll get some more charcoal. And that's all it is one spark powder and one charcoal. When I get back from taking the T-Rex out, then we'll have plenty to go. All right, so today we need to finally do this. Put the saddle on here. Look at all this meat we've got for you. Let's keep working on your melee damage. And let's take all of that. Yeah. That's awesome. We're going to transfer all to here. And then we're going to put some spoiled meat in this thing. So much meat. Can we get all of this out of here? I don't want really all of it, but most of it. Look at how much of that we have. Wow. Yeah, we're not going to have any trouble getting food probably ever again. Can we do it? That's as much as we can do. Turn on. so much extra stuff. Oops, I didn't mean to give my food there. Come back here. Oh, wow, we actually have more than I thought. I did mean to give that. Just kidding. All right, we got our trank arrows all loaded up. Get on our Rex here, and let's go the other direction this time. Oh, you know what? I don't want to leave that gasoline going the whole time. It'll go for a little while. It's fine. All right. No. There it goes. That's fine. And are you leveled up again? Wow. Hanging around level ups. Love that. I really do. Especially with the Echo of the Canyon. Okay, let's go kick some butt out here. I think we need to work on your stamina too at some point, because you are not going to be able to sprint much. Is that Caprasuchus out here? Are you going to be able to take me right off the T-Rex? I don't know. Oh, that's a Dodecurus. There it goes. Looks like you can't take me off my mount. You can poison me, though, which is annoying. There we go. Oh, wow, and he's all out of stamina. Yeah, that's what we're going to work on next for sure. Yep. Don't need the bow at all. So excited that he leveled. Oh, man. So much fun. I don't even need the meat. You guys saw how much meat we've got and how much hide we have back there, too. This is just... It's great. Alright, I'm going to keep doing this for a few minutes. Actually, while we're waiting to get our stamina back, let's look at our engrams, because we have 200 and something points, 229 points sitting around, and we can look and see what we can get now that we're level 60. I just got the Rex saddle and didn't even look for anything else yet. Let's see. Rocket launcher. Man, that's going to be a lot of materials. Industrial grinder? I think we need electric for that. I don't think we can use gas. That looks like that's really all we got. Metal tree platform. Wow, I haven't seen any trees we could do that on here. You know, we're doing pretty well, really. 65 is going to be the next big thing for those trank darts. That's going to really change our taming game. And I don't know, again, like if the basilosaurs or the... where was the other one here? Tabeharas or the Chalicotheriums. I don't know if any of those are in Scorched Earth. We might have to go back to the island, transfer our character over there just to see some of the other new dinos at some point, but not right now. Now what we need to do is figure out what the next big project should be. So if you guys have an idea of what I should do as the next project, definitely let me know. I think it's going to be a bigger base somewhere. Even an area like this that's got a nice flat terrain would be fine for building a base. And we're not going to abandon the other one in the canyon. It's really good, but like, imagine the kind of size of a structure we could build out here. You know better than messing with a T-Rex? Is that what's happening? Too bad. Nope, now your friend's going to get it. That's awesome. Let's see. Keep working on stamina. That's going to be our big holdup. And I don't need most of this stuff. There we go. Yeah, so, man, this is pretty tempting. It's not far, but we might need to build something much larger in terms of, you know, having some fabrication, and maybe we play with a little bit of electricity, get some wind turbines, that sort of thing. And I don't know if the wind turbines actually work better if they're higher up or not. Does it say on here what that does? Let's see, wind turbines. Oops, wind, not wimp. Just says converts the force of wind into electricity. So I don't know, but we'll get those and we'll get the S plus ones. We got the Ingram points for it, and then this way we can probably, you know, pick those up and move them if we need to. All right, so we're back. Our Rex is up to 63, and I've grabbed some of the meat out of the industrial grill, put it as wherever I could. This feeding trough is pretty full. I think we need to work on a preserving bin because, man, this is just packed with stuff, and I have the rest of the cooked meat on the Rex. Over here, though, we are still working on burning wood. It didn't take very long to get the Rex some levels, and that charcoal takes a little while longer than I expected. Let's see about preserving bins then instead. Let's see, bin, and somebody said that the salt pots might be better. Let's go ahead and get this too. I think that's what it was. Was it, that's preserving salt. Is it called? That's a cooking pot. What is that called? Jar? Maybe it's a jar? Oil jar? Nope. I know there's something else that with the preserving salts. Maybe that's what we do. Preserves food. Okay, that's not super helpful. Unless you can just use that in the preserving bin? Maybe you can. I'm not seeing anything else that looks like it's kind of a preserving... Oh, vessel? Ah, stores preserving salts and makes them last longer. Okay. And then... But is that just for the salts? I guess so. What do we do... What do we do with those? Seems like it'd be odd to get this high a level before you could really get any kind of preserving jars. Beer barrels? I don't see anything else that looks like it might be it. So I think we're going to try the preserving bin and the salts and see if that makes any difference. We'll do a little experimenting with that here in a minute. We can also play around with a wind turbine and the refrigerator. Let's go ahead and learn the Ingram for that because it might be worth it. It really might. Let's see what we can do so far. All right, so we've got the salt recipe, which can't be made there. It probably needs to be made in a mortar and pestle. Yep, preserving salt. We need raw salt and sulfur. We've got sand. Where do we get the raw salt? I don't know. We don't have any salt or any sulfur, so we really can't do anything with that anyway. So let's just do the preserving bin for now. And stone, wood, thatch, and fiber. Do I have any of that stuff here? Thatch, fiber. Oh, I got those backwards. Don't have any stone. I think the only stone and wood I have is either cooking up or in here. There's stone, and we need to get a little bit of wood. Let's just do this the other way. Let's get the hatchet. Oh, that's right. We got to go out through the gate because we walled this all off. And the downside of single player is I'm not generally online long enough for the trees and things to regrow up here. Come on, get out of there. So we're going to have to go a little bit further out. But we did just clear out all the crocs with our wreck, so I'm not too worried about getting attacked by them. Although they do respawn faster than trees do. We'll see what happens. Yep, there's one back in that lake already. Alright. And then how much wood did we need for that preserving bin? Probably not much, right? There we go. Preserving bin. So I know this will work, and we can use this, put it out there next to the industrial grill with some spark powder at least, and that'll get us some regular food. We can get some oil and make jerky, and that'll be all right. Okay, so let's go back in here. Oh man, I hate that you can't close that on the inside anymore. I gotta run like around and try and get through it. There we go. Those doors seem to be hard to interact with for some reason. Let's go ahead and put our preserving bin down. That doesn't need to be on a platform, so we won't put it on one. Let's put it right. How close can we get it to that thing without clipping into the terrain? Right there. Yeah, that'll work. And then we need to grab some spark powder. Let's go ahead and throw this extra wood in here. Still need all that charcoal for gunpowder. And where was that? Let's see. Get that stuff out of there. And we're going to need some spark powder anyway. Can we make some more? We're going to need more stone for it, aren't we? Let's just go ahead and gather some stone up here in a minute, too. We got all this flint because that's what the Anklos get a lot of. Let's do that. And then I think the Rex has the other cooked meat. Yep. Actually, yeah, it's fine. We can leave the meat on you. There we go. We got plenty of that. And let's just grab up some of this regular raw meat. I don't know how much of that we can put into the grill at once. Probably ought to pay attention to that at some point. That's 663. Transfer all. A lot. That's the answer. A lot. And we'll leave a bunch of this raw meat in here for our dinos as well. There we go. Alright, so I'm going to wait for that to cook up. I'm going to go gather up some stone, and I will be back in a few minutes when we are ready to make some gunpowder. Alright, so we've got enough charcoal made into gunpowder now that we should be able to make some bullets. And we can make 22 bullets. So that's not a lot, but we're going to save most of this up until we can get to the trank darts anyway. Let's go ahead and grab most of the metal out of here, about half of that. Throw that in here because I think that's going to be our holdup. Weapons, ammo. Oh, no, it's the gunpowder. Okay, so we have a little bit of metal left. We got 5 gunpowder left. We do have some more cooking, but once we get that stuff, that we're going to be in really good shape. All right, so let's take the RG out, and now what we can do is actually, oops, come on, ride. Get a better sense of where we are in the grand scheme of things. The map is helpful, but being able to fly up and actually look down and see where we are is going to be, I think, very beneficial. There we go. That's our little part of the canyon that's walled off. It'd be fun to kind of run ridges across this part, too. Wouldn't that be neat? I'm going to have to play around with that idea at some point. And we talked about having another little base structure over in this flat area, but we can now start to fly around up to the very top of these things. Like, what is that up there? I don't even know. Something Bronto, probably? It's got a big old tail. Yep, I know. We're hot. It's a desert. We're going to be hot a lot. Oh, no. It's just a Morellotops. Stuck up here. Well, let's get him unstuck. We gotta be nice. What do you? There's a couple of you up here, huh? Just stuck. We don't want you to be stuck up here forever. Wasting away on your own. There we go. Is your friend fall? He's free. Okay, well there you go. But what's up on these things? I know we looked at this a little bit with our moth earlier. Man, look at this. Just sweltering desert. There's the obelisks. You know what? Let's go check out the obelisk, actually, because there's a chance that before I stop playing on the other island that I managed to upload anything, I don't remember whether I did or not. This is going to take a few minutes. And while we're heading out this way, we'll just try to keep our eye out. So that's that. Head for those things, and we're right on the other side of that to go home. Good deal. And as we get more experience with the RNG, we're going to work on our speed, too. Stamina's not bad. But this is just not a super fast bird. And since we don't have a pteranodon to use for quick travel, this is pretty much going to be it. We're going to have to make this RG our all-in-one bird. And then, you know, if we need a combat RG later, we can tame up a different one. Not too bad. I think we can get there in a reasonable amount of time. The other thing we can start to do now is actually go beacon hunting a little bit. So there's that green one over there. Man, all the heat waves. It's pretty cool looking, but it makes it a little hard to see where you're going. Alright. That's cool. I didn't even notice the flowers on top of these things before. That's funny with the render distance, they just pop up. They all bloom when you get nearby. Pop, pop, pop. Alright. Big ol' obelisk. Not too bad at all. And we've been sprinting the whole way over here, believe it or not. That is sprint speed. And you can see our stamina is only at about half, so this isn't terrible. In terms of stamina, I think we're okay. I think it's safe just to go ahead and pump movement speed. Oh, wow, that's a cool oasis. Wow, that's really nice. Really good looking. Let's see what we've got over here. So if we land... Come on, land. There it goes. Oh, hey! Ooh, I can't see anything. There we go. Oh, raptors. All the raptors. Caprasuchus too. Wow. All right. It looks pretty. Very dangerous. Thank you, RG. Do we have any tributes? No, those are the... Okay. Wow. So I don't have any... Is that... Am I using the right thing? Yeah, I think so. Deposit items for tribute. Transmit arc data? Download creature data. Nothing. Oh, bummer. Okay, but that means we know we can do it. So we're going to have to be able to go get maybe a Quetzal at some point and bring it over this way. It was worth a shot, and we got to see what this looks like, which is it's very cool looking. I like how pretty that is. Lots of fish, too. Wow. And this, since this is single player, we could actually set up a little structure over here. That's tempting, too. We might have to do that in the future as well. Let's see if there's green beacons still going to be there when we land. And the other thing I want to keep an eye out for is any of the new dinosaurs. We saw... Pegamastix, I think is what it was called, or one of those type of things earlier. The thing that stole our meat. When we killed it, we did get our meat back. I just didn't notice it at the time, and it ended up on Tracy. And so when I was, you know, doing some inventory management when we got home, I found that. But, oops, come on, land. There you go. That means at least some of these are new. Take all from inventory. Wow, we got a lot of stuff. Paintbrush? Hold on, let's see what we got here. Cooking pot for making dyes? Some flame arrows, a couple of boomerangs, parachutes, that's nice. Primitive whip, I have no idea what that does. I mean, it keeps your foes at bay and keeps your herd moving. But yeah, now we can make some other stuff. Maybe we'll go ahead and make some dyes and dye our armor too at some point. Figure out what we want to do to make ourselves a little bit more stylish. But I like that the green drops aren't totally useless. There's enough stuff now at low levels and a variety of things that makes getting those pretty useful too. I'll tell you, man, playing Scorched Earth for a while does make you thirsty. Seeing this parched desert and all these heat waves. For sure. I really like this kind of cactus forest, too. It's nice. Man, I'm trying to figure out where we want to set up the next little structure. I think what we probably want to do is have a bunch of them, like, scattered around. Can we get yellow beacons? I think we can. Let's try that. That's right on the other side of our home base anyway. But yeah, having some little bases scattered around be useful. I'm not dying very often, knock on wood. There you go. But if I do, it'd be nice to have a base pretty close. And as we get into gathering, I do want a Quetzal, but if we can't get a Quetzal, maybe we'll have to do one of those Paraceratheriums and just take that up and down the river, because there's a little bit of metal there. That's where I've been usually going. You know, get some, run it back, throw it in the forge, run out, get some more. But if I could just forge it as we were going, that'd be pretty nice too. Oh, more blueprints, and we got a ramshackle Morella tops. Okay. Oh good, flamethrower ammo. I'm sure that would be quite useful in a desert in particular, but man, I don't think I want to bother with the flamethrower. I'm also wondering if it puts out a lot of heat when you're using it. It should. And come down this way. There's our little gate. Alright, so we're going to keep doing some exploring here, but I think this episode might be a little bit short. Apologize for that. Got some things going on in real life. And let me know what you guys think about this. If you got ideas for a new project coming up, let those go in the comments below. I'll definitely keep an eye on that. You guys know I like to take your suggestions. If you have ideas for a name for the Rex or for the RG, let me know that too. It's been fun naming things for what you guys are interested in as well. And apologies if some of your comments are on older videos. I don't always get the notifications on those anytime quickly, and often I've already named things by the time those suggestions come in. But if I do see something that I haven't named yet, and you guys have a cool suggestion, I will definitely use it. And again, same thing goes for projects. If you have one of those, let's try to come up with something together here. Cooking pot. Put you over on this side, because we don't need you in the on a structure. Large storage boxes, that's kind of cool. Can we put a couple more in the house, maybe? Probably not easily. We'll just throw some outside over here. That's fine. Maybe we can get them on this side over here, behind the rocks. No, too tall? Yeah, it's going to clip the rocks. So probably instead what we'll do is put them over here. Maybe we can cover up some of that grill with our storage boxes. Definitely a fire hazard, but don't worry about that. Eh, it'll work. Let's see what else we have. Another mortar and pestle. That's pretty nice. I think we'll put one of those out here, because we end up having to run back in the house a lot to use it. That looks like a good spot for it, right there. And then everything else I think we're just going to throw in our storage chest. Maybe we'll use one of these for kind of miscellaneous gear that we collect. It's like boomerangs, and throw some extra arrows in there. Paintbrush. I'm pretty sure we have some extra arrows in the house and some extra trank arrows in the smithy as well. There's some arrows, throw that in there. And we have trank arrows in the smithy somewhere. We sure do. All right, let's throw all of that into this chest. And there we go, like that. Yeah, so now we've got some backup equipment when we need it. I really don't need any of this extra meat, but I think that's gonna do it for now. So hopefully you guys liked this episode. If you did, please be sure to hit that like button. If you really liked it, then make sure to subscribe. And as always, I've been Brickwaffle. Thank you for watching.